Alright, what's up YouTubers? It is Keith, going to try and knock out a quick video on a recent item I picked up here by a fellow YouTuber. His channel name is Knives, Guns, and Gear. And he's got a growing channel. You guys should go check it out. Subscribe to him. He does knife reviews and different things like that. And he was selling some of his knives. And you know, one of the knives was this RAT-1 right here. So I said, you know what, man? I'll take that off your hands. I'd rather give him the money and support than some big box store or anything like that. So we did the exchange, and he sent it out very quick, and it arrived to my door. But this knife right here, the RAT-1, I've been on the fence about getting one of these for a while now, for an EDC knife. Just because I know it's a budget knife, and I've heard mixed reviews, but the majority of the reviews is that it's a great EDC knife. And so I picked it up, you know, a lot of reviewers said that you can abuse it, holds a good edge, and overall it's a good knife. Now my everyday carry, I carry a couple blades on me, but the one I use the most was the K-Bar TDI. And that's a fixed blade, small little blade, great defensive blade. But if you guys have it, you know that the Kydex sheath that it comes with sucks. And the clip on the back just continued to open up and get loose. Of course, I'd rebend it and shape it back to where it can be tight on my belt. And I don't wear a huge belt. I just wear a regular rigger's belt. It's pretty thick, you know, Cobra buckle type style rigger's belt. And it just continued to open up and get loose and loose and loose. Well, I guess, you know, it was too loose. And one night while I was riding home from work, it fell off while I was riding my motorcycle. I didn't notice. I got home and I noticed my blade wasn't on my hip anymore. So that sucked. So I carried the TDI and I lost that. So, which is a great, great knife. I'm gonna replace that as well. But I carried that and this. This is a Kershaw Cryo. This is a great, great knife. If you guys don't have this little knife here, it's a great, great buy, man. They've got the new. It's not new now, but it's fairly new. Is the black wash. It's a real rustic looking finish on it, and I want to pick that one up. But I got this one, so, and this one's still servicing and still kicking, so I'm not gonna replace it. But this is a great EDC knife, this Kershaw Cryo. Great, great, great knife. But with that being said, the RAT-1 right here, you can see it's noticeably larger in size. The blade length on the RAT-1 is 3.5 inches, and the blade length on the Kershaw Cryo is 3 inches. And 3 3/8 of an inch. So, you know, it's just a little smaller on the blade size, but the Kershaw Cryo is 5.5 ounces, 5.5 ounces, whereas the RAT-1 is 5 ounces. So you get a bigger knife, in my opinion, more ergonomically comfortable. I mean, it feels better in the hand. You get a full grip on it, so it's more comfortable in the hand for me, the RAT-1 than the Kershaw Cryo. I still like the Cryo. I still will carry it, rotate it in my EDC rotation, but I'm gonna be carrying the RAT-1 as my EDC carry for now on. But I just wanted to make the comparison, because although this is a smaller package, it does weigh more than the RAT-1. And for me, the handle, the feeling of the RAT-1 is just a lot better than the Cryo. The Cryo is a great knife. Of course, it has a hinder design to where you won't over travel on your lock. There's a couple of differences, of course. You know, I'm not trying to compare apples to oranges, but as an EDC comparison, I'm gonna have to get used to the RAT-1 because of its size. I don't cry about big hefty knives. I don't. I just want to stress the difference between the size, or the weight rather, because that is a big deciding factor for a lot of guys or gals carrying EDC knives. I just want to make that point that out is that although this is smaller, it is heavier. And of course, the blade design is different. The grind, the edge on it is different. It's a different grind. There's pros and cons. I mean, there's a lot different features to each blade itself. And of course, both have the option of carrying left-handed or right-handed. You can carry tip up or tip down. Depends on the end user, but you have that option to switch the pocket clips to which suits you best. The Cryo does have a deep pocket clip that sits lower in your pocket. Some guys like that, some guys don't. I personally don't give a crap either way, but it is something that you know to point out. But anyways, enough about the Kershaw Cryo. And then the Kershaw Cryo does have two methods of deployment. The flipper on the back and the thumb studs. So that's one thing that I do have gotten accustomed to, was that that option of the flipper, which it opens extremely fast and smooth. The thing about the Cryo that I've noticed is that it does have blade wobble, a little bit of blade wobble. It has a torque screw, which you can torque it down. But if you do that, you got to notice that it's a torque screw. So if you tighten it too much, that will prevent the assist or the smoothness of the opening, the assist opening, or what have you. So you want to find a sweet spot, but there still will be a little play in the blade. Now on the RAT-1, there is absolutely no play whatsoever. This thing is just, it feels sturdy, and it's built really well. The deployment on it on the RAT-1 is pretty good. Like I said, I was been used to the flipper on the back, but you know, that thumb stud works perfect, and it is ambidextrous, has the thumb studs on both sides. So this will be my new EDC carry. Just thought I'd like to share it with you guys. I do really enjoy the Cryo. I'm gonna still keep that in my rotation, but for now on, I'm gonna be packing this beast of a blade. I mean, it is a little fully deployed. The full length of the knife itself is just over 8 inches. So it's a good size. I like bigger knives, and it's just razor sharp. When he sent it to me, I was really surprised in the condition. I knew he it was going to be used, and it wasn't going to be new, unopened or anything like that. But when he sent it to me, it was in its original package, and even the knife itself was, the RAT-1 was in its bubble plot, in its bubble wrap. So I was kind of like, no, this can't be brand new, but I don't know if he ever carried it or used it. There isn't any wear on it at all. As you can see, it's like a nylon handle on it, and it is a liner lock, as you guys can see. And it's just an altogether nice. I'm pretty pleased with it so far. As you can see, the blade itself is pretty well centered. When it's closed, it's pretty well centered. And so we'll see how this goes. But it's a very, very nicely made, feels very stout and robust, very rigid. Of course, it's the Aus-8 steel. So, and this is an Aus-8, but this is the, what is it? It's the China MOV, the stainless, the China steel that they use, stainless steel that they use. But both are very sharp out of the box, and we'll see how this one, the RAT-1, holds its edge. So, hope you guys just like this first looks at it, and go check out Knives, Guns, and Gear's channel. Give him some support. He's down to earth dude, and you know, I just want to, I'm really happy with the transaction of this RAT-1. So stay tuned. I'll tell you how it goes as far as EDC in this. But all together, great looking knife, very sharp. And you know the saying, a safe knife is a sharp knife. and if that makes sense, you know, because you don't have to use much pressure, and this is a very sharp knife, so I feel very safe with it. It's not dull to where I have to use over pressure to compensate for the blade. So that's how people get hurt. But you know, this is a very sharp knife, so we'll see how it holds up. All right, guys, take care. I appreciate the love and support. And you know, I'm just about, I don't know, I'm just under 3,000 subs. So once we get that 3,000 subs, I will be doing the giveaway. So stay tuned. And someone's gonna make out like a bandit, you guys. So take care, much love, and I'll see you in the next video. See ya.